Matthew's gospel has a very long introduction called the genealogy of Jesus Christ before we get to that verse 18, which we began with. And once again, I decided to spare you all of the so-and-so became the father of so-and-so became the father of so-and-so, which goes on for about 10 minutes. And so then that actually is very interesting to examine, but we're going to try to keep it light and simple. And so I'm going to talk to you a little bit about a negative subject that goes into a positive subject. So if you'll bear with me, it's basically about the meaninglessness of life that moves into actually the meaning of life. And so then we have to set it up, and it might sound like, why is he going to talk about this stuff at Christmas, right? Well, because we have to be set up to appreciate the gift that Jesus Christ is. So what is your view of life? What is your view of creation? What's your view of existence? Many people have somewhat of a humdrum view of life, believing life is mostly average or ordinary, and many even believe that life is meaningless. So here's an example that most of us can relate to. I think everyone has heard the song Bohemian Rhapsody, right? Okay, so if you don't, well, we'll show you the song later, but it'll be a different version of it, a happy version. But Freddie Mercury of the English rock band Queen first released the popular song Bohemian Rhapsody in 1975, and the lyrics represent quite a negative view of life, even a meaningless view of life. Now, I'm not sure if anyone has actually took the time to read those lyrics, but the lyrics actually represent a very interesting story of a son crying out to his mother, telling her that he just killed a man, faces capital punishment, tries to avoid it, believes nobody loves him, even acknowledging that Beelzebub has a demon for him, but in the end does not really care that he is about to die and perhaps even lose his soul because, as the song sings, nothing really matters to me. Now, the Christian view of life is much different. Our worldview is that the Almighty God has created everything. The moon, the sun, the stars, the galaxies, every grain of sand, every blade of grass, every cell in your body has been uniquely and intricately created by God. And the Almighty, all-powerful, always present everywhere God looks upon you as if you are only universe he ever created. All his attention is on you. The Christian worldview is that God created everything good, and his goodness in creation culminates in none other than the human person. And the human person has meaning to God beyond anything we can ever imagine or ever understand. Our value to God, our worth to God, cannot even be expressed appropriately because every human language falls short. Each and every human person ever conceived is created so good that it is impossible for any human life to lack meaning. So where does the understanding of the meaninglessness of life come from? Why the culture of death that surrounds us presently? Well, the simple answer is that we experience the consequences of sin. So we experience the consequences of sin. Because we sin as fallen human beings, we experience the rupture and destruction of our relationships with God and with every other person that we come into contact with. The consequences of sin enslave us to our own passions and ultimately to the devil himself. So our continued choices for sin become a life as if of being humanly trafficked against our will, and so sin then entraps and imprisons us. And simply put, this condition of ours is what leads many to believe that life is often meaningless. Now, what is God's response to our horrible condition? What is his response to sin? Well, the Holy Family, we have a statue up here of the Holy Family. I'm not sure if you can see it, but here's Joseph and Mary, little baby Jesus. All right, and so we have the Holy Family. Now, why are they here? Why is the Holy Family here? Well, to fight is the answer. They're here to fight. The Holy Family is here to fight. Why is Jesus here? Why was Jesus sent into the world? Jesus was sent in the world to fight. He's here to fight. Jesus Christ and Him crucified is what we as Christians have to offer the world. Jesus Christ and Him crucified is the only thing we have to offer the world, and it's the only thing that brings meaning to life. Our Christian story of God's creation, the fall and redemption, is the story of God's unimaginable, unfathomable, and incomprehensible love for us, for you, as if you were the only person He ever created. All His attention, all His love, because He's so infinite that He can love each of us as if we are the only person He ever created. So God's shocking response to sin is His Son Jesus sent to destroy evil. Jesus came to rescue us from that which we cannot escape from. Jesus on the cross is Him going to war for us and winning victory over the devil by dying in the flesh. He deceives the devil. He becomes part of death. Death is what is owned by the devil. But since Jesus is divine, death is exploded from the inside. He deceives the devil by His own death. He attacks the devil. He raids the realms of the dead. And He destroys the power of death once and for all, attacking the devil and delivering him a crushing blow. This is the meaning of Jesus on the cross. He has come to save us. Our job, then, having been rescued from sin and death by Jesus and His cross, is to go and rescue other people, by our public witness to God's amazing love for us. God's amazing love story, for which we are His beloved, the object of His amazing love. This is our job. You are missionaries. When you leave here today, you are going to be witnesses to God's love, God's amazing story, that you take what you just learned from the Holy Mass and you use it to save other people, to help people realize how incredibly loved they are by God. That the God who has created the entire universe, all the different galaxies and all the billions of stars, He created you, and His attention is on you. This is the God whom we come to know. And we often minimize sin and its consequences, which causes us to undervalue God's response to sin and undervalue God's love for us. So we want to know and live in God's love for us, and when we do, our lives and everything we do cannot be meaningless. Life is impossible to be meaningless with such a Savior and such a God on our side. And so now we are going to conclude where I began, with an example. But not the example of the Bohemian Rhapsody that focuses on the meaninglessness of life, but rather a parody called the Bethlehemian Rhapsody. And if anyone has not seen this yet, it is posted to our website, but we're going to show it to you right now. So it focuses on the way God's love has been shown through Jesus, His story and our story.
Nativity, caught in a census in the town of His ancestry. Open your eyes, look up to the skies and see. He's just a poor boy, foretold by prophecy, because the wise men come. This is how God's love shows. It's a wondrous story to me.
To me. Mary just got the word. The angel did appear, but he told her not to fear. Mary, now it's just begun. Your son is gonna wash our sins away. Mary, ooh, the God who reigns on high has sent his son through you to die for all.
Of a sheep. Shepherds watch over their flocks at night time.
Angels shout like lightning, very, very frightening.
Peace on earth, peace on earth, unto you is Father's Day.
I'm just a shepherd, nobody loves me.
He's just a shepherd from a far family. Angels that go to the stable and see.
Wise men come, wise men go, will Herod let him live? Joseph, Mary, Joseph.
Mary, Joseph, better go to Egypt now. God has saved your son, prepare for me. For me, for me.
So you think that it's just a tale of days gone by. But this child who was born went to Calvary.
I didn't create it. But it's good applause for God who sends his son into the world. So anyone can understand that, all right? Even a child can understand that. So this is the beauty of our Father in heaven who shows us his love by sending his son for us. This is the ultimate gift of Christmas. Don't ever lose that meaning.